Now here some alphabets are written. Now what is the first thing that come to your mind when you see these alphabets?
Well, either the word element comes to our mind or the word symbols comes to our mind.
So these are actually symbols of elements. Now let us try and see how elements got its symbols. The first method which scientists used to obtain the symbols of elements was to take the first letter of the names of elements as its symbols. It can be an English name or it can be a Latin name. In case of oxygen, now oxygen is an English name of an alphabet of an element, and its first alphabet is O. So the first alphabet O was taken as symbol of oxygen. Whenever we take the first letter as a symbol of any element, then we always write it in capital letters. It always have to be a capital letter. Similarly, talking about another element, potassium. Potassium is an English name of an element. Its Latin name is kalium. And the first alphabet of kalium is K. So the first letter of this name was taken as a symbol for potassium. Now, all the elements cannot be represented by the first letter as its symbols, because there are several elements which are starting with the same alphabet. Like for example, cobalt. Cobalt starts with C. Now, we cannot choose C as a symbol because the C represents carbon. So, the scientists thought of choosing two letters from the name of an element. Like in case of cobalt, they chose the first two letters, that is C and O. So, whenever we are choosing two letters as a symbol of an element, the first is always written as a capital and the second letter is always written in small. Similarly, there was another element, bromine. It's if we write B, B represents boron. So we chose two letters of its name, that is B and R. B was always written in capital and R is written in small. So Br is a symbol of bromine. Then in some cases, the two letters of the symbols were chosen from the Latin or German or Greek names of elements. Like for example, copper. Now copper is an English name of an element and its symbol is Cu. Now this symbol was chosen from its Latin name cuprum. Now the first two letters of cuprum are C and U, which were taken as its symbol. Now here, if they have taken this symbol from an English name, like for example from copper, if they have taken Co, it would have meant cobalt. So that's why in some cases the scientists thought of choosing or using their Latin names for the symbols. Similarly for iron, its symbol is Fe. It was taken from its Latin name ferrum. The first two letters of ferrum are F and E. So here the symbol of iron is Fe. Now this is how the symbols were chosen for elements. Now what does a symbol represent? Whenever we write on the symbol of an element, it represents that element. Like for example, O. O represents oxygen, but it also represents one atom of oxygen. Similarly, if we write N, N represents nitrogen, but it also represents one atom of nitrogen. So keep that in mind, that a symbol of an element always represents one atom of that element.